For billions of years, nature has filled the world with colors. But have you ever wondered, where does color come from? How does it work? Well, it turns out that nature uses two main ways to make colors, and both of them are used by birds. Let me show you how. Red birds use pigments, and blue birds use structures inside their feathers. If we do an experiment and we grind down the feathers of the red bird into a fine powder, it will look red, just like we would expect. But if we do the same with blue feathers, the color disappears. And that tells us that the material in the blue feathers isn't actually blue. So what's going on? Well, red birds have molecular pigments or absorbers in their feathers that absorb the blue and green colors. So the material of the feather is red. This is the same as the pigments in your clothes, for example. But blue birds don't have these pigments. So the green and red colors simply pass through the material. And the structure inside the feather reflects only the blue back to our eyes. When we destroy the structure by grinding it into a fine powder, we also destroy the color. I'm an applied physicist, and when I learned about structural colors, I loved it. And I also fell in love with birds, as you can tell from my dress. Because you might think that colors are simple, but actually, there's so much physics behind. The physics of light and colors and how it interacts with structure. So, how does light interact with structure to make colors? Let's look at an example. A blue Kapenga bird feather. The internal structure of the feather is made up of a packing of small spheres, about 1/100th the width of a hair. And when researchers mimicked this structure using nanoparticles, they got the same color as the bird. In a simplified picture, this structure reflects only the colors or wavelengths that are similar in size to the nanoparticles, and all other colors simply pass through. Now, if we make these nanoparticles larger, then these longer wavelengths can now fit in the structure and reflect back. This is the basic physical mechanism behind structural color. The color comes from the structure and not from the material itself. However, to make structural colors for applications, we cannot just simply rely on mimicking structures from nature, because the structures that we see in nature are often much more complex. Because birds, for example, have other requirements, like they must be light enough to be able to fly. But we don't have these requirements, so could we design structural colors using simpler structures instead? To answer this question, I embarked on a research journey 3 years ago, and along with collaborators in Professor Manoharan's lab, I developed a computer model that predicts the color from a structure. Here's how it works. We have our simple model, our simple structure, and we model light using solutions to Maxwell's equations. We actually model light in the form of photons, which travel through the material, getting scattered along the way until they exit either by passing through it or reflecting back. At each step, the photon decides how long the next step will be and in what direction, based on probabilities derived from scattering theory. These probabilities depend on the sample parameters, like the material of the nanoparticles and the medium, the packing density and the size of the nanoparticles, and the thickness of the material. I also derived the effects of other parameters, like the variability in the size of the nanoparticles, the presence of absorption, since many times birds use a combination of pigments and structures, and the effect of surface roughness. By physically capturing the features of real-life samples, I was able to achieve, for the first time, quantitative agreement between experimental data and model. And this is important because it means that we can predict the exact color from a structure, and we can do it fast. We can use our model to understand what parameters control structural colors and venture in a field that has been inaccessible to us until now. The precise control and design of structural colors for applications without having to rely on mimicking structures from nature and using simpler structures instead. So, what's next? Well, structural colors have unique properties that pigments don't have, which make them more versatile. For example, structural colors are tunable. Because the color comes from the structure and not from the material itself, we can make different colors by just changing the structure using the same material. This is exciting for applications like making sensors or electronic displays, like a paperwhite Kindle, but colored. Also, structural colors can be safe. We can design structural colors using safe and environmentally friendly materials. But our model is not limited to just colors. It's really a model of light. We can design coatings that protect against UV radiation or smart windows for more heat-efficient and sustainable buildings. And lastly, our model can help us understand nature. As I said earlier, red birds use pigments. And to our knowledge, there are no examples in nature of a homogeneous structural red. So then our model can help us understand why that is the case, and if it is at all possible to make a homogeneous structural red. Our goal is to use our model to not just mimic the structural colors we see in nature, but maybe go one step further and make colors that not even nature has been able to make. Thank you.